Yeah, sorry. You have to take the microphone.
It's going to be all right for you with sound?
Oh, no problem.
Okay.
Don't worry.
It's hotter this time than it was when I was here last. I don't know. I'll remember a lot of things. You know, one of the things I'll remember is just seeing people that I love, musicians, you know, that have taught me so much and it welcomed me in. Last night I saw musicians who were a part of my very first gigs, like first gigs in Atlanta, when I knew probably 5 standards and I was sitting in at jam sessions. We were all in the same room together and right before the show. And that was really emotional for me, really exciting. I'm really glad you asked this question. we all suffer, but we, you know, it shows up in different ways. So I think that sometimes this kind of overstating of suffering in relation to blues and to, you know, having depth can sometimes be overdone if we go after it. You know, it has to be sincere. Whatever it is, it has to be sincere. I think it's important that we not have to directly associate, you know, depth and mastery with suffering. Wellness is very important to me. You know, I practice yoga and I run and swim. So this is a different day. You know, this is a different time. But to be human and to love at all is to suffer some. You know, you can't avoid it. I think music surpasses religion. I think music is like you know, water or air. It's elemental. Of course, it can be very sophisticated, but we can do to it what we want. But it is a medium of expression that surpasses, you know, the languages we have built and the ideologies that we have built, you know, civilizations and cultures upon. And it speaks to our primal selves and also, though, to our refined mind at the same time. So I just find music to be an immediate and affecting language. And, you know, it's like our animal sound, you know, it's our very basic thing. So, yeah, it's a real gift to be human and have music. And the variety of music and the way music captures our history, it's what an incredible gift we have. I don't know, that's a great question. I don't know, maybe Caetano Veloso or something. I would love to just play percussion in the back. I don't know. But you all have great archives, and I actually go to a favorite cafe in the Atlanta airport when I have a long layover, because they're always playing them on TV in this library. So I go and I face the wall, and there's like 2 different monitors, and I'll just watch until I, like, you know, catch my flight. So, yeah, I love it. And I have some of them at home, but I don't have, you know, I know that the whole collection is staggering.
Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Really?
I mean,
we could.
And we can turn
I would say more.